So, Dillie, who's your critic?
Well, girls of a certain age group will remember Darell Rivers, who was the head girl of Mallory Towers by Enid Blyton, and she's reviewing The Joy of Sex by Alex Comfort. The Joy of Sex is not a book for anyone who does not like beards. Nor is it a book for open-air types with a love of hockey. However, it has to be said that a good informative sex guide is essential reading for girls of a certain class about to leave school and embark upon life. Therefore, it behoves each and every one of us to find out about this rather revolting occupation of sex, which apparently is so necessary. Is this, however, the handbook for a Mallory Towers girl? Frankly, I do not believe so. One would have to get over one's initial revulsion at the line drawings which picture a naked man with the aforementioned beard. Yuck! And a bored girl who looks as if she'd jolly well rather be out playing netball against St Ethelred's on a lovely, crisp, wintry day. I can't say I blame her, having seen the rather too clear drawings of the penis, which, in its sleepy state, seems to resemble a sort of chopped-off parsnip. And two absolutely titchy little haggises that have burst in the pan. It sounds a bit like our cook's school effort on Burns Night, but not nearly so much as ripping fun. Once one is past the pictures, if that is possible, there is the hideous question of the text. Anything more revolting would be hard to imagine. Once I got to the bits about tongues and toes and ceiling mirrors, I felt slightly nauseous and I went for a spiffing swim in the cove, even though it was February. As I said to Sally, who shares my study, what is wrong with a banana? Anyhow, as we fed the book into our cheery stove and heard the cocoa boiling away merrily, we felt a lot better. Later that evening, Sally snuggled up to me, massaged my buttocks and said, "Chin up, old girl, there won't be any beards at Girton." What a relief!